scheduled for five minute rounds.
Time. Ready? Ready? Fight!
Round number one.
Russia against Mongolia here, the stand-up knockout artist against the submission machine. Who's gonna come out on top?
This world title fight is brought to you by Ruji Ah Beijing, Sports and Development Company Private Limited. Gray trunks for Gafurov, black trunks for Jadambaa.
Jadambaa coming with some wild strikes.
Effective on that outside low kick.
He's known for these big, wild, swinging punches that come from all angles, from very unorthodox. The crowd is exploding here, supporting these amazing fighters that we have in the cage at ONE Championship. The energy, you can feel it.
Big left hand landed by Jadambaa. Then circles out. Hands high and tight for Gafurov. Hands high and wide for Jadambaa. That belies the confidence that he has in his lightning strikes.
Gafurov has been spending a lot of time in the strength and conditioning. He wants to have his endurance and stamina be one of his most dominant attributes. But he's also been focusing on his strikes. He knows the danger that Jadambaa presents in every single exchange.
The crowd is chanting Tunga. That's their nickname for Narantungalag Jadambaa. I guess chanting Narantungalag Jadambaa would be a little much. So we're gonna miss to the body.
It is a mouthful. You can see Jadambaa just throwing these wild strikes, and that's what really captivates the crowd. They love this offensive style. He's produced some of the most spectacular knockouts in MMA.
Another hard outside kick. Marat Gafurov walking through it. There's the level change.
Jadambaa knew this was coming. He knew that he would be put in these kind of positions. Let's see what kind of defensive strategy he has as Marat Gafurov spins him around and puts him up against the cage.
Knee to the inside from the Russian. Forward, 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 forward. 2:35 remaining, watch round out, number out, one. Champion versus champion. Dynasty of Champions here in Beijing.
Marat kind of a sacrificial throw, puts himself onto the ground. I thought he would attempt to maybe play some guard, but that's really not his game. He likes the top game jiu-jitsu style. He likes to pass the guard. He likes to impose his will, drop some ground and pound, and set up the possible rear naked choke.
Jadambaa, a wide base, very effective. Big knee to the body. Nothing on that counter knee from Marat Gafurov.
I like to see the knees inside the clinch when it's up against the cage, because if you start kneeing the legs, you start kneeing the body in a five-round fight, Sean, that's really gonna impact the later rounds.
Go ahead.
And you've got to remember that Gafurov has never been past the third round. He's never had to fight in those championship rounds.
Into the body from Gafurov, but they're not landing cleanly. You see just grazing the ribcage. Counter from Jadambaa.
I'm impressed with the takedown defense of Jadambaa. You know, even when Gafurov has both underhooks, which is usually a dominant position for a lot of wrestlers, they're able to control the upper body and kind of move you into whatever positions you like. And Jadamba's just got that wide base, that deep Mongolian strength.
The waist cinch, nicely done on the turn. Good right hand. In and out with the striking for Jadambaa. Through the combination, finished with the right, but pulled back to the center of the ONE Championship cage.
I've talked to a few of Jadamba's opponents in the past, and they said they haven't quite ever felt the strength of this weight. Now, Jadamba's spent a lot of time fighting at lightweight, and now he's in the featherweight division. That makes it even more dangerous when it comes to the strength position.
Another hard outside low kick. Gafurov eating those, making no attempt to check.
And this jam-packed crowd in Beijing, we're hearing multiple languages being screamed in Russian, in Mongolian, in Mandarin. They're coming out with all kinds of different languages at us.
The end of round one. Closing sequence, Jadambaa getting off with a solid left hand. You see the Mongolian flags. Incredible atmosphere here at the National Olympic Sports Center in Beijing.
Here's that attempt at a takedown. Gafurov attempted to get that double on the hook where he tried to attempt the hip throw. Jadambaa defended very, very well. He is initiating a lot of the striking exchanges. He's more active on the feet, and he's defended the takedowns, and he's ended up on top when the fight actually did go to the ground. So far, if you're going to stop the fight at this point, you've got to give the nod to Jadambaa.
Look of poise on the face of Narantungalag Jadambaa.
Big deep breaths. He says he channels the spirit of Genghis Khan in all of his fights to represent the entire nation of Mongolia.
He is a huge athletic star in his home nation. Mongolia, among the more than 70 nations watching this broadcast.
Ready? Ready? Fight!
Round number two. ONE Championship, Dynasty of Champions. Our second world title bout of this stacked card with Mitch Chilson. I'm Sean Wheelock. Glad you're with us watching around the world.
Sean, we've got a billion people watching around the world. The energy, the excitement that's here in Beijing. I wish you guys could feel it as these two featherweight champions get it on.
Gafurov, the body kick, then the level change. And again, you see the wide base of Jadambaa. Gafurov going hard for the takedown, looking for the scoop.
Very impressive takedown defense shown by Jadambaa. He's able to keep that wide base, control the fight, and not let Gafurov get it to where he wants to be, where he's so dangerous on the ground. We are right above us right now, fighting for position. Big takedown.
Fully down. On his knee, the full level change, the takedown. Now caught in the head scissors.
Watch out, watch out.
There's a pot as strong as Jadambaa is. You could possibly just crush the head of Gafurov.
Jadambaa clinging to this on the head scissors, now lets it go. Now on the armbar, and that is tight. Looking to finish. The arm fully extended, now hyperextended. Close taking a really close look. The legs controlling the body of Jadambaa. Jadambaa gets out, back to head scissors, now an inverted triangle with the left arm in.
Jadambaa getting out of a deep armbar where he was in such danger of the fight beat, and his arm was completely hyperextended. Now he's got a triangle, an inverted triangle. He's got to try to pull the foot down, cinch it so he can actually lock in the triangle.
And Gafurov slips free. Use the slam to open the space. Now back to side control, now neon belly for Gafurov. Back and forth we go.
Jadambaa's in a dangerous position here. He's got to try to get off his back and start moving away. You do not want to be on the ground with a submission specialist like Gafurov, especially in a defensive position as he is in right now.
Gafurov nearly finishing, full torque on that arm. On the armbar, Jadambaa showing incredible tenacity, not to tap. And then catching Gafurov in the head scissors with the arm in between the inverted triangle.
Gafurov side control. Has 2 minutes to work here, Sean. This is a bad position as he tries to pin down that arm.
Looking for crucifixes, Marat Gafurov.
You gotta wonder if that arm was damaged in that brutal looking armbar.
Gafurov really tight and heavy with his Brazilian jiu-jitsu, stepping over the full mount, and he stepped out of it in the half guard.
Now he's just going full neon belly. He feels a little bit more control better where he starts to punch from this position. He might be setting up enough. He likes to pin down that arm. He's just trying to soften Jadambaa up a little bit.
Short knee to the head. So interesting, though, this. Gafurov stepped over into mountain and stepped right back out of it.
I don't think he believes that Jadambaa is soft enough. I don't think he can finish Jadambaa right now. So he wants to punish Jadambaa.
Back in the mount from Marat Gafurov. Trying to spin again for the armbar. Neon belly once more. Fluidity with the top game of the Russian.
So he's choosing to go neon belly to where he can deliver more devastating ground pounds. Gafurov has been in the top position for the past 3 minutes. Having a world champion on top of you. He's a two-time Abu Dhabi world champion. And Jadambaa's up!
Out the back door. Gafurov got a high in the full mount, and Jadambaa took the back door escape. Outstanding fight, outstanding second round. 30 seconds remaining.
Huge hard shown by Jadambaa. We thought the fight was over. I thought that was it. I can't believe he's still standing, throwing punches.
Jadambaa lands the left hand. Gafurov so fluid with his top game, looking for submissions, and still we fight on. That's final seconds, round number two. Marat Gafurov, the interim champion. Narantungalag Jadambaa, the world champion. We're going to round three to unify this title.
Hey, no flash, no flash.
Here we go. As we look back in the previous round, we saw some back and forth action. Here with that nasty armbar. Gafurov got the arm underneath the armpit, completely hyperextending the arm. His arm is going the wrong way. It's not supposed to do that. But the huge heart shown by Jadambaa as he muscles out of it and then threatens his own inverted triangle. What a tremendous back and forth exchange.
All right, ready? Mouthpiece, guy, mouthpiece.
Gafurov needs his mouthpiece.
All right, ready?
He gets
ready?
So into the zone, they
fight!
Just forget. I don't think it was all intentional. I just think he gets so into the moment. Such a huge fight like this, so much at stake. He's just afraid. His mouthpiece in.
Nicely done by referee Olivier Coase, doing the mouthpiece check. Referees would have missed that.
I don't know, Sean. Marat Gafurov looks slightly fatigued. There's a slight bit there. Jadambaa pushing forward. Marat shoots in for a takedown on the single leg. Goes up to the upper body.
You expend energy defending subs, and you expend energy attacking with subs. Gafurov was attacking hard with subs in round two.
But when you don't get it, when you miss, you put your heart and soul into it. What happens is it gets in your head. It starts to get at you. What happened? Why didn't I finish? I had it.
Gafurov bit in with the legs. A lot of torque on the arm. Narantungalag Jadambaa just would not tap. Showing the heart of a champion that he is. Even Gafurov.
I do believe the channeling of Genghis Khan,
run defense,
the ultimate warrior,
run defense.
The ultimate tough guy,
run
proved
defense.
Right there in round two as he fought off that armbar.
Jadambaa throwing a knee.
Let's go, guys,
look. Knee to the thigh. Coast calling for action.
I wonder if Jadambaa's sensing something because he's not pushing away, he's not trying to initiate the striking exchanges. He's trying to drain, he's trying to lag, you know, suck more energy away from Gafurov.
Gafurov throwing those knees, but just not much power behind them.
And Jadambaa, remember, Sean, Jadambaa is a
good left hand,
10 years older than Gafurov.
Eating that lead left hook, deftly thrown and landed by Jadambaa. Again, Gafurov, no attempt to check the kick. We have not seen him check one kick in this entire fight. just eating those.
You're not used to checking kicks, Sean. You don't want to do it for no reason at all. They hurt. Like, they sting on the shin. If you ever bump your shin into a table, it hurts. Imagine that's a giant Mongolian swinging his leg into your leg. Taking a leg.
That's what Gafurov has been doing.
And it's going to slow him down as we eat into these later rounds.
Leg kicks, much like body punches, blows of attrition.
Nice left hook on the entry there for Jadambaa.
Step in with the knee, that lands. Jadambaa turning up the temperature. Position there for Jadambaa. I'm not even sure if he knew he was in Wizard.
Uh-oh, sweeping around to the back now. Now,
giving his back. Gafurov looking for his favorite submission to finish. The rear naked choke, walking on the body triangle. Jadambaa in all sorts of trouble. 125 remaining in round three. Jadambaa's got to play all defense. Smart tactical defense here. That body triangle is locked on tight by Gafurov.
Another submission attempt successfully defended, but this is a bad position. This is Gafurov's favorite move. And Jadambaa sneaks around, spins around into the full guard.
Gorgeous by Jadambaa. Escaped the body triangle, then he's floating the turn. In and out of submission danger.
There's Narantungalag Jadambaa. Possible guillotine here. It looks like he's actually now just kind of controlling the head position.
No commitment to the guillotine. Just stabilizing the throw the knee to the left hook. 30 seconds remaining. Jadambaa to the body, to the head. Left hand, right hand. Gafurov is rocked, circling up. Big left hand from Jadambaa. Now opening things up, closing stages of this round. Huge uppercut. Jadambaa landing big. Gafurov backing off. The bell cannot come soon enough for the Russian. High deep kick to the face, just misses the mark. There's the shot, the takedown. Gafurov fights on. We fight on to round four. Phenomenal. Gafurov, Narantungalag Jadambaa.
What an amazing three rounds of action. This is back and forth. The submission attempt here by Gafurov as he sinks in his favorite move, the rear naked choke. It is so difficult to get out of the body triangle, but Jadambaa's heart, determination, muscles through. The suspense is building constantly as he pries that hand off. Here's some big punches. That starts getting this round swinging in his way. Another huge left, right overhand that does the damage. Rocking Gafurov, putting him in a lot of danger. This is a huge back and forth fight with constant ups and downs.
Absolutely amazing, Sean.
On your scorecard through 15 minutes.
At this point, we've got constant back and forth action. This is a two near submissions by Gafurov, give him a slight edge because he wasn't in such dominant positions so far. A very, very slight edge to Gafurov, but the heart and determination as we push into these championship rounds. This is uncharted territory for Gafurov. He's never been to this round.
Great look at our crowd. Outstanding venue, National Olympic Sports Center in Beijing. A venue for the 2008 Summer Games. In our venue for Dynasty of Champions. This our second world title fight of tonight. Stacked and outstanding card. Marat Gafurov as we enter the championship rounds. The one featherweight interim champion, Narantungalag Jadambaa, one featherweight world champion. Two belts coming into the cage, only one belt. That's to the winner, who has his hand raised at the end.
Sean, I do want to correct myself. Gafurov has been the distance in the other organization in a five-round title fight, but he has not been into these championship rounds here at ONE Championship.
Second from Gafurov. Big swing and a miss with the overhand right from Jadambaa. Level change, single leg attempt. You see the big, wide defensive base from Narantungalag Jadambaa. He's very difficult to take down. And he doesn't sprawl, he just bases out. Now Jadambaa opening up his striking again. We saw this effectively at the end of round three.
But Jadambaa can keep the distance, keep Gafurov away from him, from getting into that clinch position. He is landing some big strikes here in these later rounds.
Stepping in with the push kick and missing. Swinging and miss, that right hand landing.
These wild punches just keep coming. He throws big looping shots and they land.
Gafurov suddenly a very defensive fighter. Backing off, taking the full force of that outside kick. .255 remaining round four. This fight has been outstanding. There's the sprawl from Jadambaa. Jadambaa turning the sprawl into offense.
Early defense shown by Jadambaa.
Was pushing Gafurov forward. Almost could have continued that through with a takedown of his own. Feels much more comfortable in this stand-up position. Again landing the outside kick. Swing and a miss. Gafurov taking the back. Underneath and down and locking on the body triangle. And again thinking rear naked choke.
Immediately goes into, locks the body triangle, which kind of just positions Jadambaa in a very tough position. It's very hard to get out of it. You can see that the rear naked choke is not quite underneath the chin, so he's not in a lot of danger. It's just, it's not comfortable. It's very, very just
watch out,
wrenching
watch out
on the chin and
watch
the neck. It's very hard to deal with, but it's not going to submit to the same way as if the arm slides underneath the chin.
Boss just warned Gafurov, a blow to the back of the head, but we fight on. Knees to the body from Marat Gafurov. 135 remaining round four, right hand. Jadambaa trying to shrimp, posturing onto his hip, now trying to turn and explode out, can't do so.
Look how he's keeping in position by using that left leg to try to control his own legs.
Unfettered shots now from the crucifix. Short forearm to the face.
Explosiveness rather than using technique to get out of here. He's just trying to throw Gafurov off of him rather than shrimping away and trying to stand up.
Gafurov back to the on belly.
But it's, I gotta say, it's tough to do that when you've got a two-time Abu Dhabi BJJ World Champion on top of your back. But
Jadambaa now giving his back. 40 seconds remaining round four. Gafurov single-mindedly thinking rear naked choke. That is tight. Both hooks in, sliding under the chin. So much torque. That is really tight. Jadambaa in all sorts of trouble. He is out. The technical submission. The win for Marat Gafurov. He unifies this world title.
Oh my God, what a tremendous title fight. We have just unified the belts here in Beijing, China, as Marat Gafurov captures the featherweight world title, interim no more.
Narantungalag Jadambaa would not tap. Choked unconscious by Marat Gafurov's vicious and lethal rear naked choke. Technical submission, Gafurov reigns supreme.
Ground display shown as the rear naked choke specialist continues his onslaught of the featherweight division with the one weapon, the choke. And you can just see no tap necessary. He chooses to go to sleep. The big heart of Jadambaa shown very clearly. You gotta put your hands together for Jadambaa, but our new featherweight world champion, Marat Gafurov.
Jadambaa still has his supporters. He was phenomenal in that fight, but Gafurov even better.
这场比赛，问大家打得好不好？这场比赛结果宣读之前，首先感谢五届北京 体育发展有限公司总裁魏永华先生 ONE Championship CEO Victor Gui 最终成绩如下最终降服 Winners Blue Corner
Referee Olivier Coase doing a nice job of recognizing Jadambaa went out the technical submission win round number 4 Marat Gafurov eliminates interim in front of the word champion and replaces it with world champion